Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at an introduction to constitutional isomers. So constitutional isomers have the same molecular formula, but a different connectivity. So a molecular formula being CX, HY, and then maybe you have some heteroatoms in there too. So there's the same number of carbons, hydrogens, any other atoms, but the way that those atoms are connected is different from one another. So let's go to the next page. We'll do a little terminology and then we'll look at a specific example. So this is for organic chemistry. We're looking at carbon-based molecules, and so it can be helpful to be able to identify a carbon based on the number of hydrogens that it has on it. So when we see a CH3 group, we call that a methyl group. A CH2 group is a methylene. A CH group is a methine. And if we have a carbon that doesn't have any hydrogens on it, so it would have all what we'd call substituents, non-hydrogen atoms on it, we call that a quaternary carbon. And so this terminology will help us as we're putting together these molecules from their molecular formulas so we can identify groups and differentiate them from one another. So here we have a specific molecular formula, C5H12. That tells us how many carbons and hydrogens I have, but not how those atoms are connected to one another. So there are several constitutional isomers that we can draw from this molecular formula. As a general strategy, I like to start with the longest chain and then shrink that chain down from there in order to get different constitutional isomers. So if I started with a 5-carbon chain and I just had it be linear, I'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's one constitutional isomer of C5H12. I'm going to number my carbon atoms. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then if I think about my hydrogens here, the ones on the end would have 3 H's, right? You've got methyl groups there. And then in the middle, you have all methylene groups. Those are all CH2 groups internal to the chain. So just to double check our numbers, 3 plus 3 is 6, right? 3 2s is 6, so you have 12 H's, and of course we have our 3 carbons, so that works, okay? Now there's only one way to put together that longest chain, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna draw a 4-carbon chain. Okay, so I have 4 carbons in a row there, and then I'm gonna need to add another carbon here. I can't add it to the end, or I'll have the same thing that I started with, and so I'm gonna add it to one of the middle ones, so maybe I'll add it to what I've labeled as 2 right there. So that would be carbon 5. Now it doesn't matter adding branching for the number of hydrogens, okay? So we do have more methyl groups. So we've got 3 hydrogens here, 3 hydrogens here, 3 hydrogens here, but now we only have 1 hydrogen at carbon 2 because it's got 3 groups coming off of it. And then we have 2 hydrogens at carbon 3, and so if we add all of that up, again, we have 12 H's and we can see we have 5 carbons, okay? Now, one thing to look out for here is duplicating accidentally the same molecule and calling it a different constitutional isomer. So for example, if I did that 4-carbon chain again, if I put the methyl group on the right side instead of the left side, those 2 molecules are equal to one another. They're the same molecule. It's just sort of drawn upside down and flipped around. But 1 methyl group, 1 carbon in from the left or the right is the same. Okay, so those 2 molecules are equal to one another. They are not constitutional isomers of one another. So watch out for that as you're solving these problems. Okay, so there were no more unique constitutional isomers I could draw with a 4-carbon chain, so I can shorten even more to a 3-carbon chain. Okay, that would give me 2 methyls left. And of course, I can't put them on the end or I'd be expanding to a longer chain, but I could put them both coming off the middle. There is enough room for that. So this would give me 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 carbons. I have 4 methyl groups here, right? So carbons 1, 3, 4, and 5 are all methyl groups. So they all have 3 H's on them. So that's my total of 12 H's. And then carbon 2 would be a quaternary carbon. It has no H's on it, but 4 substituents or 4 carbons coming off of it. Okay. And there's not any other way that I could put together the 3-carbon chain. I had to put my 2 substituents on the middle, and that's what I can do. So those are all constitutional isomers of the molecular formula C5H12. remember that you can start from the longest chain and shorten as a systematic way to try to make sure you get all the constitutional isomers and to look out for duplicates. Okay? This has been a look at constitutional isomers. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.